In today's video, I will be working on writing a code to implement AVL tree. AVL is a balanced binary search tree, and it has the property of binary search tree that the value at the root node is greater than all the values of all the nodes in its left subtree, and is less than all the values of the value of the nodes on its right subtree. And other than that, it has one more property that is called balance factor, or it is said that the height of difference between height of left subtree and right subtree shouldn't be any value different than minus 1, 0 or 1. If it is 0, then height of left subtree and right subtree are equal. If it is minus 1, that means that there are as we are subtracting from the left height of left subtree to the height of right subtree, then this means that the when it is minus 1, the balance factor of the root is minus 1. That means that there is one more node at the in the right subtree. If it is 1, then there is one more node in the left tree. Or it is called, if it is positive value, then it is called that left heavy. That means there is one more node at in the left subtree. And if it is minus 1 in negative value, then it is said that there is more node on the right subtree. So that is we are going to implement. We create one header file for this tutorial, and I will say so. Okay, first I need to something like struct AVL node star insert. And we will get a node called, and we will get a AVL node, and that is going to be the root, and we will get a value which is we will be inserting in this root. And I will check that if null is equal to this root, then we are not going to perform any value perform we are not going to perform any operation. Next is I will check that if data is less than a value in the root data, then the value should be inserted in the left tree. Root, go to the left tree and put the data in it. Else, if data is greater than root data, then we have to move to the right subtree. So I will say right So here I will say new node, new AVL node, create AVL node, or new AVL node is name is better with this data. So if that value is not there, then do this. Insert the value. If data is equal to root data, return root, because we are not putting any duplicate value in it. Okay, this is the basic insertion. This is how we do basic insertion in a binary search tree. We need to create this structure, AVL node. I will say that struct AVL node star left right, because most of the operations that we do we are moving towards the left or the right, so we are doing that. So I'm putting these pointers at the top. AVL node, next we're going to have our data, and next we're going to have height. AVL node root int cost data. Struct AVL node, no, it is not. We just only going to need this data, and we will return a new AVL node from this, and we need to implement this AVL node, and I will say struct AVL node star AVL node. Struct new node is equal to a struct malloc size of AVL node, and I will say new node left is equal to new node right is equal to null, and new node data is equal to a zero, and a single node has a height of 1, that is itself. So we have this value and height is equal to 1. Next we are going to return this new node, so we are returning the new node. Let us arrange this equal operators. New node is, so we have our all functions defined for us. Let me compile it once. Implicit declaration, so I'm missing dot h. It provides me with functions like for memory allocation and deallocation. That is that, and compilation is done and it is okay. So now we need to balance the root of this tree. Now we need to balance the check the balance factor of the node and balance those nodes. So first we need to update the height of this node, because one extra node has been added to it. So we need to update that, and next we need to calculate the root balance factor of a VL node. I'll pass root in it, then I will check that if root balance factor is greater than 1, that is if it is left heavy. If there are that new node has been added on the left side of the in the left tree of this node root, then we are going to go in this if statement and do some operations, and we are going to check that if data that we inserted is greater than root left data. Root left data. If it is greater than root left data, that means that the new node was added in the right subtree of its left child. So I will say right a is equal to rotate left, rotate left, and root is equal to rotate right. So here is the, for example, how to say it. For example, something like root is, this is root, and we'll say this is the left child, left child, and this is the left right child, and this is the new node. So in case new node was added over here, then we will have simple right rotation, that the L will become root, and this root will become the right subtree of this L. But in the case of where data is greater than root left data, that means that data is greater than root left, this is greater than the value of this L node. So this is going to put in this right node, in this right subtree of the left node. So because of that, we are going to first rotate this LR to come at the position of L, then we rotate again in the left, so that LR will come over here in the position of R. So this is what rotate left is. We are rotating toward the left, then we are rotating toward the right. This is what rotation is. Else if balance factor is greater than less than minus 1, in that case we will check that if data root right data back is less than root right data, that means that the new data has been put in the left subtree of the right child. So we will say first rotate left, rotate right, write this left subtree, rotate return route. So we have updated the nodes. I'm updating the right node because we have some issues over here, because we need to rotate it to the left side. Similarly, we have updated the left node, then we update the right node. Then we return the root. So what are the missing functions that we have over here? We have update height function. I will say int update height struct avl node star. Int update HTAGST if null is equal to root, then return 0, there is no height. Otherwise, we are going to say root t height is equal to max is equal to 1 plus max root left root right, and I will say return root height. So this is how we are updating the height of the root, and we need to create a max function. So I will say extern int int max int constant, and I will define it int constant number 1 int constant number 2 so return if number 1 is greater than number 2, then return number 1, otherwise return number 2. I will say inline this function. So we have our values over here. And the issue is we need to call the height function on these nodes. And so we have update height, then we have a max function, and what else we are missing? Balance factor of AVL node. So I will say should be constant, and this should be constant because we are not updating any node. So I will say balance factor of AVL node. Okay, so now we need to define the balance factor of AVL node. I will say balance factor of evil node struct root char struct avl node constant root if root in null is equal to root return 0 balance factor of avl node and then we need and balance factor of a node is height of left subtree minus height of right subtree so it is going to be return I will say something like height left minus height of the right node I can put that if a statement over here and say then return 0 and you can see that how concise and small programs can be written in C so height is and we need to define a height function Height function is used, but it is not defined anywhere. Height of root left and height of root right. Okay. Int height of AVL node struct AVL node. Star constant height of AVL nodes. Height of AVL node and Let's compile this code once more. Implicit declaration of function rotate left. Okay, it's not declared. Rotate height. Undefined reference to height of AVL node. Okay, yes. I have renamed the function, but I haven't defined it this function yet. So let's start doing that. Int height of AVL node, and I will say struct. Node star constant root if return null is equal to root then return 0 else root inline. So we need to define a rotate left, rotate right functions. Insert function is done. Struct. I will node star. Rotate left struct star since we are going to update the value of this node root node, if we are not updating the value of the root node, then we'll declare the parameters as constant. So if null is equal to root, return null, because we cannot rotate a null node. Otherwise I will say struct avl node star rotate left, that means we need a left node, left child of root. Equal to this root left, left child of root, root left, and then we need access to the right of this left child, right of left child root is equal to left child root right. So we will be rotating left only when there is a right node, otherwise we won't be rotating that. So we do not need to check for check that the left child of root is a null value. Left child of root right. Then what are we going to do is that we need a struct star left of right of left child of root is equal to, because the left child of this variable that we have declared right this below right of this line is going to be the right child of the left child of the root. So I will say right of left left. So next, now we are going to swap the roots nodes. I will say that right of left of child root dot left is equal to left child of root and left child of root right is equal to left child of root. And now we need to update the left node to right of left child of the root node. As we are not modifying the value of the root, so we can say that this is constant. And I will say something like extern struct rotate left. So after we do that, we need to update the height of this street. I will say update height of left child of root update. As these have been rotated, so we need to do the update height of right of left child of the root update height of the root. So this is done, and I think the rotate left function is done. Next, we need to move to the F. So our left rotation is done. Next is to rotate left. It is to rotate right. Rotate right as struct. Return null. So code is compiles without any issue, and we need to implement the logic now. Struct. Now we need rotate right. So we need a right child right. Left of right child left of right child, then right of the right child, that is going to be the left child of right child. So it is confusing, but it makes sense. Right of left of right child dot right. Right child and left of right child, right of left of right child. We need to swap the nodes. I will say the left of right child dot right is equal to right child, right child left is equal to left of right child is equal to right of left of right child. And next is root right is equal to root right is equal to left of right child. Rotate left, rotate right, all functions have been implemented. For debugging purposes, now we need to be able to print a node with a description and print tree, print avl node. Print tree, print avl node. Otherwise, we're going to say print. Data is data, and height is height, and this is printing a node. Next I'm going to say void print avl tree constant. Avial tree with indentation root separator repeater. So I will have to declare this function static print avial tree with indentation struct avial node constant root char constant separator char constant repeater. I will say something like if null is equal to root return return void so and next I will say something like print avial tree we are incrementing the what is called height distance from the left of the terminal so that if it prints we will be able to distinguish that it is a right or left node which that this is a sub child of the root so with that is done I will say for int I is equal to 0 I is less than repeater I printf c is equal to separator and done and next is going to be print avial node root printf a printf avial node print avial node the root and then we are going to say print avial tree with indentation root repeater so I think we can test our insert functions now left of right child is a pointer did you mean to use this yes I meant to use that I will say gutinchar struct h head is equal to nu AVL, node and head is null is the root. Now nu AVL node doesn't take any node, takes the value, I will say 35, put in that, I will say print AVL tree. So we have our AVL tree printed. I will say back it just provides some space after a tree has been printed. Not over here. And so we can print our node data is equal to 0. Why is that? Because we are setting it to 0. You can see that it is working, our code is working now. And let us insert some more data in it. Forty-seven minutes and still streaming, long time. I'll say insert head and insert 37, and I will say I'm going to make this so 37, 38, 39. So if 39 gets added to this tree, the tree is getting to get unbalanced, and we'll have to perform left operation to fix it. So now we are going to see that in action. Looks like compilation issue. Something broke. Segmentation fault again. Thirty-five, thirty-seven, and 39 is giving us some issue. When this issue is happening, during the print or during insertion? During insertion. Let us see some insert. Update height, root balance factor of AVL node, root. I don't see an issue. So we need to balance the left side of the tree, not the right side of the tree. So this is wrong. Straight left, right. Over here I need to say right. Something I missed. Just run it again and see if this happens or not. Segmentation fault again. Rotate right. Root left, root. So let me check something. I will say print. So debugging 35, 37. So balance factor is minus 2, so that means that the root has been already inserted in this, and I will have to say (37, 38). So root is already inserted in this, and we are getting some issue while rotating it. So data is this less than greater than root left data, that means that data has been inserted in the right. This is going over here because it is the root balance factor is minus 2, so it is less than minus 1, it is going over here. So it is on the right tree, 35, 37, 38, right side. The issue is over here and we need to rotate it to the left. So this is going to be here, data root right is greater than data. No, this is not going to apply. So issue is going to be in the rotate left, and we are going to see this issue rotate left over here. So this is the issue where this is the where we are going to face our issues or face our demons. And I will have to say that update update height right child so the issue is in the rotate left part. And what are we facing? So this is root is 30. What are we adding? Root is 35. Left of is null. So I have written this rotate functions in a wrong way. Rotate left, then I will say struct right node, left of right node, right node, left of right node. Say right child that is this is 37 Now we need to swap, we need to make the 37 as the root. So I will say right child or left is equal to root. And right child left is equal to root, and root right ray is equal to left of right child as now root now root is comes below the right child, so we need to update the height of that root first. So we have returned the no, this is not correct again. Right child, this is the parent now, and need to also update this over here. We have said root dot left and root dot I think these values are also constant. I will say left child left right of left child left child, left of right child, right So how we are going to do to date, right? I have a node. Right of left child. So left of child is right is equal to root, and root left is equal to child. So rotations are fixed. So how it is happening? A bit confused. Right, left. Left of root. This. Okay. Let us start again. Update height, update. So you can see that our tree is balanced now. So here the balance factor has became minus 2, and we rotated it and 37 became the root. By this is the right tree, so by left rotation it became the root and the tree became balanced. Then we this is the intermediate state print operation, and print avl. So now we have our balance tree, and let us do the function to delete the node. I will say something like extern struct delete avl node. Return root, I'll say return null. It is more clear that what I'll be returning. So the basic implementation is same, that if data is less than root data, then move to the left. So root left is equal to delete AVL node, move to the left data. Else if greater than root and delete right. And next comes the part that there is a difference in this and the last, is that we need to keep the update the root in the binary search tree. If there was deletion, we could have made this root as the constant, but in this case we need to update this root variable so that we can do rotations after this delete operations. So when if we are in the else part, we have found the data, we need to perform some operations. Let us return something from here. And root left, root right, delete AVL node, and root is definitely not null, otherwise we won't have reached here. Null, and null is equal to root free root, and root is equal to null. So we have freed the root and it is null, and we have found the node, and it is a leaf node. Next is the case where else if root left, that means root right is not null, otherwise we have got inside the if statement if block above this else if block. So I will say something like struct temp is equal to root, right? Free root. Root is equal to temp. I think I will get some issues that we are assigning a constant pointer to a non-constant pointer. So I removed the temp, removed the constant declaration something. Root is equal to temporary now, so root has moved to next. And next case, I will take that else if null is equal to root, right? Then means that root left is not null. So I will do the same thing over here. This is a code duplication, but it is make it more clear. And free root. Root is equal to temp. So if we are in this else statement, that means what it means that we have both nodes inside. Both this is not a leaf node, and this node has both the trees. So both subtrees, left subtree and right subtree. To do that, I will say struct star temp again, root left, while temp right not is equal to null, temp is equal to temp right. Struct evil node star temp root left, null is not equal to temp right, temp right. So find the maximum value in the left subtree, and I will say that root data is equal to temp data, copy it, and root left is equal to delete avl node left, and data. So we have covered all the cases. And so coming over here, I can say that because this is the leaf node, so basically there is nothing below it, so we do not need to make any rotations. We can do some refactoring and combine this in one place, but I think it is okay, or we can combine it. Null is equal to root right, I will say then left node, otherwise root right free root, and root is equal to temp. Root left, root right. If root, the right subtree is null, then set it to the left subtree, and vice versa. I can get rid of this. Balance factor of ABL node. If one is less than balance factor of root, that means the root is left heavy. The data has been deleted from the right side, and next is else if balance greater than balance factor root. Balance factor of a root, balance factor of ABL node, done. Now, so if I'm going to check that, if factor of right so balance factor root, it is left heavy, and if it's right child, left child, okay, because we need to know in which tree the data was added, deleted, sorry. Balance factor of ABL node on the left, how it is going to say. Left. What is saying that if the root is right, no, root is left heavy, there are more number of row nodes in the left side, but the left child of that left subtree or the parent of the left subtree is right heavy. What this mean? This means that node was deleted from the left heavy and rotate right. Rotate, okay, yeah, rotate right. There are more number of nodes on the left side, so we need to move one of the nodes to the top so that number of nodes on the left side will decrease. So I will say similarly over here. If root is right heavy, then we need to rotate to the left. So root is right heavy, left heavy, then we need to rotate to the right. If it right heavy, then we need to move it to the rotate to the left. In the case, if you're considering the children, that if they are if a left heavy root has a right heavy children, left heavy root and that heavy has a right heavy children, rotate to the left, rotate to the right, rotate to the left, rotate to the right. If 0 is less than balance, right, rotate right. Okay. So delete function is ready. So it says that this is a normal binary search tree deletion. This is the ABL part. We update the height of the root and then we check the its balance factor. If it is unbalanced, it is left heavy balanced, then we rotate it to the right so that number of nodes moves from left to the right. But if we check that if it's one of the left child is not balanced, that is it has value more than 0, more number of nodes are presented in the right, no, more number of nodes are present in the right subtree, and we need to balance that, then we rotate to the left and like that. So this is delete function is done. Let us test some delete after I'm making few more insertion. I will say twenty-one is already there. 2. Let us create this and implicit declaration of function delete avl node. (11, 9) delete avl node. Delta. Another one is 119. Delete deleted. The final node and root is 37, and this is the left subtree. And in this left subtree, 21 is the root. This is the right subtree, and in this right subtree, 38 is the root. So we are going to delete which one? I'm going to delete 29. Let us see what happens after that. So 29 is gone and the balance factors are right. Let us check the height of this tree. We have 3 nodes on the left side, so height should be 4, which is right, because the height 3 is the maximum height. And so the balance factors are right. With this code, this AVL tree insertion deletion is over, and search is same like that of the binary search. So thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.